we will learn about the topic VLANs and trunking. So quickly, what is a VLAN? What does exactly it do? So VLAN divides a single broadcast layer 2 domain into multiple layer 2 domains, and it also provides security at layer 2. So when I'm talking about layer 2, I'm referring to the OSM models layer 2 data link layer. Now VLAN 1 is the default VLAN in any switch, but in some switches which are business class switches, it allows us to create our own virtual LANs. For example, for Cisco switches, we can create VLANs from 2 to 1001, but the maximum limit is up to 4096 VLANs we can create in a single layer 2 network. Now, these VLANs is a feature that is only available on manageable switches or programmable switches, that is business class switches, not general home switches. Now why VLANs? Now usually if you see a network which is interconnected to each other using cascaded switches like this, so you will see even if a single ARP request is coming from any computer, so that would be broadcasted everywhere, and most of the traffic will be either broadcast traffic, okay, which will cause unnecessary bandwidth usage in the entire network. For suppose, let us say there is one computer which want to find out the MAC address of a server. Now it would send a broadcast message to find out the MAC address of the server, which would be ARP request. Now the other machines would also get that message, but obviously if it is not for them, the ARP protocol in those machines will ignore that message, but it would also cause some precious CPU cycles and also bandwidth which is used in these intermediate devices and the switches or the switches. Okay, so we don't want these things to happen. So this is technically called as flooding. We don't want flooding to occur in our network. We want everything to be controlled in our network, even at layer 2. So what do we do? Well, basically we create multiple VLANs. Now what exactly is a VLAN? Now again, I'm saying you, VLAN stands for virtual LAN. That is a network inside a physical network. So physically we can create a single network if you have one switch, okay, but some switches will support VLANs which will allow us to create multiple networks within the same switch. It's like a virtualization. The concept of virtualization, if you are aware, in a single computer, if you have a virtualization software like a hypervisor, we can additionally install multiple operating systems. In the same way, inside a switch, we can create multiple VLANs or multiple virtual networks. So what is the use of this? Suppose if in a business you have multiple departments and you don't want this department's traffic to flow to each other. Okay, so from security point of view, let us say you have three departments, the HR department, the marketing department, and then some sales department. Now for HR department, their payroll management software and the database of employees is really important for them. You don't want that data to be accessed by people who do not need them. For example, marketing people or sales people. So how do you protect them? Well, basically there are multiple security controls you can implement to protect this data, but the best one is a VLAN, because VLAN implements a security control at a lowest level, that is layer 2 itself. Okay, so you will not even have access to any of these computers, because they are isolated at layer 2. That is the biggest advantage. Now practically you will see these VLANs everywhere in most of the enterprise class networks and business class networks. So suppose you have a wireless network. We all know that wireless network is not secure. You want to keep it separate. You don't want the wireless traffic to interfere with your own production network or your servers, because wireless networks can easily be hacked. Okay, the access points can be hacked, the wireless devices themselves can be hacked, anything can happen in a wireless network. So all your wireless network traffic, you want to isolate them. So again, you create a separate VLAN for the purpose of wireless, and that traffic can be routed through, you know, a layer 3 devices if you have, to the internet or anything like that. And also the server farm, whatever you have, you also want the server farm to isolate itself from the actual production environment. Okay, because if a virus or a malware spreads in one of these computers, the malware, it will be difficult for it to actually go to a different VLAN unless and until the intermediate devices are allowing. And again, if you are designing VLANs, there is one common rule as suggested as best practice. Every VLAN will have its own IP subnet. So for example, you will see here this VLAN in the brown, earth brown color here. You see 192.168.1.0 is the IP subnet which is assigned to this VLAN. And the green color VLAN you see, it has also got its own IP subnet 172.16.0.0. This is another rule when we are designing a VLAN. Now how can we extend the VLAN? Now if you look at the left side, these two computers, if they want to communicate with these two computers 6 and 7, which are sitting on a different switch altogether, which means we are able to extend the VLAN from one switch to another switch. And if you look at the link between these two switches, okay, so this link itself is called as a trunk link. Now that's when we come to the trunk. Now a trunk link would actually help the VLAN traffic from one switch to move from one switch to another switch. So trunk link would carry multiple VLANs, multiple VLAN traffic from one network to another network. Suppose here, so we have the blue VLAN, red VLAN and native VLAN. Native VLAN is the default VLAN. By default it is VLAN 1, but we can change it if you want to. Now there are two switches here. Now these two switches, if they want to communicate, you know, multiple VLAN traffic, so they need a link which would help them to communicate with each other. Alright, so that's enough theory. Let's see the practical part, how to create a VLAN, how to add ports to the VLAN and all that stuff. Now here I have a Cisco Packet Tracer. So this is the common software which is used by most of the students, and because it's easy to create networks and VLAN. So I have, we'll take three computers here and we will create three different VLANs here in a single switch. Now I am going to connect these three computers using a straight cable. So here I am connecting the first computer to FA0x1. The second computer, PC1, I am going to connect it to 6. And then the third computer, I am going to connect it to 11. Okay. The idea is simple. I want FA0x1 port to 5 to belong to VLAN 10. And then FA0x6 to 10, I want it to be part of a VLAN called as VLAN 20. And then FA0x11 to 15, I want it to be part of VLAN 30. Alright, so this is my idea. So how do I create that? Now because this is a programmable switch, I'll directly go to the command line interface, either via console or via telnet. So once I have access to this, I will read the manual. Now for me, I already am aware of the commands in Cisco IOS. So I'll jump here, and first I'll change the name of the switch. Now I'll create VLANs. VLAN creation is really simple. So before I create any VLAN, let me show you one more command. Existing VLANs. So how many VLANs are already existing? So you can see here, the command is do show VLAN. Now here we can see, by default, there is one VLAN and all the ports are members of this particular VLAN. That is the reason any computer which you connect to any of these ports will be able to communicate to the other port. Communication can happen between the members of the same VLAN. Remember that. Communication can only happen for the members which belong to the same VLAN. Now I am going to create a VLAN. The creation of VLAN command is really simple. All you have to do is type VLAN and VLAN number. I'll give a name here. Let's call it sales. Now VLAN 20. I'll give a name. Let's say prod. And then VLAN 30. And I'll give a name here, IT. Alright, now if you look at the VLAN database again here, you will see I have created three VLANs. Okay, so this is supposed to be prod. I give it PROF, my mistake. We can change it if you want. So VLAN 20, name, prod. That's how you change the name of the VLAN if you do make a mistake. There you go, name change. Alright, now we will add the ports from FA0 by 1 to FA0 by 5 to sales VLAN. So how do I do that? Let me show you. First I will show you how to add individual ports, and then I will show you how to add multiple ports at the same time. So here, to add an individual port, I need to type here INT FA0 by 1, then switch port mode access. Now when I give this command switch port mode access, actually I am saying to the switch that the device which is going to be connected to FS0 by 1 port will be an endpoint device, like a computer, a laptop, or an access point, or a telephone, something like that. Then again I am going to add switch port access VLAN and then VLAN number. That's it. Now I have made FA0 by 1 to be a member of the VLAN 10. Now if I want to add multiple ports at the same time, then I have to use the range command here, wherein I will have to simply mention the range of the switch ports which I want to add, and then I can add the membership in this way. Now I have to repeat the same command for rest of the port. So here you can see, I'll just simply change the range command here. So from 6 to 10. And then again switch port mode access, switch port VLAN 20. And then again interface range. Now this one will be from 11 to 15. And then switch port mode access, then switch port VLAN 30. Simple. Alright, now I'll save this configuration, show VLAN. Now you can see here the ports have been redistributed into the respective VLANs here. Okay. Now these three computers which are connected to these ports, alright, they are on three different VLANs. That's how I create VLANs and add the membership. Now, what is a trunk port? As I told you, trunk port would carry multiple VLAN traffic from one network to another network. So here I have three computers, similar computers. Okay. Now, if I want these three computers to communicate with their respective VLANs here. So let's say suppose there is PC5. If I want to add PC5 to VLAN 10. How do I add that? Well, first I'll connect this to FS0/1, but which VLAN is FS0/1 in this switch? It is by default to belongs to VLAN 1. So you can, here you can see enable show VLAN. FA0/1 belongs to default VLAN, VLAN 1, and there are no VLANs we have created here. Okay, so before I do any of those that stuff, let me explain to you the concept of trunking. Well, trunking is basically a point-to-point connection which we are going to establish between two switches. Okay, now here I have chosen carefully the port. The port number 24 I have chosen. The reason I have chosen port number 24 is because in the real networks, if you look at the switch rack, there will be huge number of cables which will be seen on the switch ports. But you want to uniquely identify the port which is a trunk port. Okay, so I have chosen a port which is in the almost in the end. It is very easy to identify, and additionally in a real time I would actually change the color of the cable. I will use a different color cable. For example, if I am using yellow color cable for all the multiple VLANs, you know, different VLANs, then I will use something different color, like a red or a green color, whatever it is. So color coding will really help in networking. Whenever you see a network rack, you will see multiple colors are there. It is really good network design if you are using multiple colors. For example, all the production VLAN, you can choose, assign one color, blue color, yellow color for different VLAN, red color for a different VLAN, green color for a different purpose. Maybe you are connecting to a router, or maybe you are connecting it to a trunk link, so that a network engineer physically would not go and disturb those cables, because he understands which color code means what. Alright, so how do we enable trunking between these two switches? Well, basically, to enable trunking, all I have to do is config T interface FS0/24 switch port mode access, because directly we cannot change dynamic auto mode to trunk mode. So switch port mode trunk. Okay, now how do you verify that? Show int trunk is the command in switching. So here you can see FS0/24 trunk mode, and the protocol which is used for encapsulating the frames, Ethernet frames, is 802.1Q. Well, this is also called as a tagging protocol, which will tag all the VLAN traffic, whatever VLAN traffic is going through these ports, FS0/24. Suppose VLAN 10 traffic is going out from the switch to another switch, so this port will tag by adding an additional, number or VLAN tag to that frame. That will be called as a tagged port. So these tagged ports can only be understood if the other end also is following the same tagging protocol. So here on the other end of the switch, I will also go ahead and make this port to work as a trunk. So switch port mode trunk. Show interface trunk. So here you can see 802.1Q encapsulation. So at this moment, a VLAN allowed is showing as only one, because I haven't created any other VLANs yet. So I'm going to create a VLAN here, and I'm also going to create one more VLAN here. Now I did not give the name. It doesn't matter if I create and give a different name as well here. So VLAN 10, VLAN 20. Oh, I forgot to create one more VLAN, VLAN 30. So let me also do that. VLAN 30. Remember here, the switches will identify the VLAN traffic based on the VLAN tag, not by the name of the VLAN. VLAN naming is only for us to understand the purpose of the VLAN, and this is always a best practice to give a name. Don't leave it default. Technically it will work, but if you want to manage multiple VLANs, so you have to know the purpose of each and every VLAN. Alright, so let me add a port FS0/1 to give you a demo of how it works. So int FS0/1 switch port mode access. I hope you remember this command. Switch port access VLAN 10. I have added this now. Testing time. So if I send a traffic from PC 0 to PC 5, I should be able to receive the traffic and get a reply as well. Alright, for this I am going to give an IP address here, so 192.168.1.1, and the same IP address I am going to give here on the other side, that is 192.168.1.2. Okay, now when I send a traffic from this switch to this switch, okay, remember here this is a trunk port, so trunk port should carry multiple VLAN traffic. So let me go to run and ping 192.168.1.2. So here you can see I am getting a reply from the other end. 4 packets have been transmitted and received successfully. Alright, now I can repeat the same action on PC4 as well. So let me connect PC4 to fast Ethernet 0x6 here. So this is just a repetition of whatever we have done here to verify trunking in action. So VLAN 20. Now here PC1, I'll give an IP address 192.168.2.1. And then this one I'll give an IP address 192.168.2.2. Okay, now let me test the connectivity here. Ping 192.168.2.2. I'm getting a reply from the other end. Okay, so here remember, because of this trunk port, the communication is happening between these two computers which belong to VLAN 10 and these two computers which belongs to VLAN 20, and even if I connect this third computer also, we will be able to connect. So basically trunk port is allowing the traffic from VLAN 10, VLAN 20, VLAN 30 as well as VLAN 1. The traffic which is allowed on the VLAN 1 is called as untagged frame, because this is the native VLAN traffic. Okay, this is the native VLAN traffic, will not be tagged. The tagging will only happen for 10, 20 and 30, and the protocol which is used between the trunk ports is 802.1Q. Now this lecture is only to give you an idea about the technicalities of VLAN and trunking as we give training to the IT administration course. Thank you.